Oh my god!
I just freaked out. But yes, I know, I'm very sad that I exist too. This was the worst joke I've ever made, but we'll just get on with the video. Hi guys! My name is Sabine and welcome to the Mid-Year Book Freakout Tag 2020 edition. Uploaded this video before or on July 2nd because I believe that that is officially the middle of the year. I'm so excited. I always love watching these and talking about my own answers to these questions. So basically this is a tag, if you don't know, in which you answer 13 questions about what you've read in this year until so far. I know that 2020 has been a really great reading year for me, but it feels kind of unfair because I have read a lot of short story, nonfiction books, but also some graphic novels. But yeah, I'm still gonna count those as books that I read because they are. Let me check my Goodreads because until so far in 2020, I have read 24 books and my goal for this year that I set for myself is 35. So I'm 7 books ahead of schedule, which is amazing. But like I said, feels a bit like cheating when you read really small books. But then again, who gives a f***? Before we dive into the questions, I have a very quick announcement of like 10 seconds, and that is that my Etsy shop is like restocked. All of the previous bookmarks that I've sold are back in stock again. Plus, I have 5 new products in my shop that you should definitely go check out. So I have bookmarks and 2 prints in my shop right now. A link to my Etsy shop will be in the description box down below, so you guys can check that out. It would mean the world to me. This was not 10 seconds, this was more like 30. So let's get on with this video. Question number 1, which is your favorite book that you have read in 2020 until so far, and without a doubt, that is this book. Radio Silence by Alice Oseman. I unfortunately have the ugly cover of the bunch. I really dislike covers with faces on them, but this one is doable. I don't know, I think the girl looks really cool. Not only just the contents of this book were amazing, I also read it at a perfect time. So in this book we follow Frances, and Frances is a study machine. All she does is study for her finals and she wants to get good grades and everything, but she is struggling so much with her future and like what she wants to do next. She only knows that besides studying, her only hobby is listening to this podcast called Universe City. Do you hear kind of the funny joke, the pun that is in that podcast? I think it's very smart. She gets in contact with the creator of the podcast because apparently that is Aled, I think is how you pronounce his name, but I've been saying Aled for the past year, so it's difficult to get out of my system, okay? He actually lives across the street from her. They are in the same school and they become really great friends. And what I loved about this book is it deals with such like deep topics and mental health issues, so a trigger warning for that, but also friendship. And there is no romance in this story, which I mean is kind of refreshing in the YA book community. I love to read more books about friendships instead of romance because I value friendships so incredibly much, and there are not enough books that have worked out this topic as well as this one, I think. And even though Frances is like still in high school and a lot younger than I am, well, a lot, like 4 years, I am 21 right now, and I've been struggling so much because I chose the wrong bachelor. Yay me! Whilst reading this book, I just felt so heard, and like all of my struggles were described in this book. I have figured out a bit more what I want to do with my future, so I just love this book so much, and it's one of my new favorite books of all time, not just of 2020. Question number 2 is your favorite sequel you've read in 2020 so far, but I think my favorite sequel is Heartstopper Volume 2, also by Alice Oseman. Be prepared. Sometimes I will be showing you guys and talking to you guys about the same books throughout this video, so I hope that you're kind of okay with that. This is a graphic novel series about 2 boys who become friends and fall in love. And that's not a spoiler. I mean, look at the covers and everyone is just freaking out about this. This sequel was so amazing. Like, all of my heartstrings were touched. Is that a saying? I don't know. I was so happy overall throughout this whole book, and it was so cute and it was so good. It's my favorite sequel of 2020. Number 3 is a new release you haven't read yet but want to. And this one is coming to me in the mail so soon, and I've heard amazing reviews about this one, and that is You Should See Me in a Crown. I hate myself. Every time that I hear this title of the book, I of course think about the Billie Eilish songs. And it is about our main character. I don't know her name. I've forgotten that. I'm sorry, but she has amazing plans for her future. Like, she wants to become a doctor and everything, but her financial situation isn't that amazing. But in her high school, you can get a scholarship when you become prom king and prom queen, which for a Dutch girl like me, that just seems impossible. I don't know if that is even real in the US. I know that people get scholarships for playing sports, which I just find a little bit questionable. But besides that, she chooses to kind of go for that title in order to get a scholarship. And the only thing that is making her school year really quite nice is one of her fellow students. I believe her name is Mika. I don't know why I am remembering her name and not the name of our main character, but okay. And I think that this is an LGBTQ book, so I'm expecting there to be some kind of like romance between the two main characters, and Mika also wants to become prom queen. So they're kind of like fighting each other, but they also really like each other as friends, or as more than friends, I'm guessing. I have heard really great things about this book, especially on Twitter, and I just cannot wait to get my hands on this book and read it as soon as possible. Question number 4 is most anticipated release of the second half of the year, and I am so bad at keeping up with new releases. I don't keep up with it, actually. So the only one that I know of and that I'm very curious about, that is The Invisible Life of Adi Larue by V.E. Schwab. I think it's a fantasy standalone, but I'm not too sure about that. And you follow Adi Larue, and she has made like a deal back in 1714 that she will live forever on the condition that people will forget her. However, 300 years into the future, she comes across this man, I believe, in a bookshop, and he remembers her. That's all I know. I think that is also just all that the synopsis gives you, but it sounds so cool, and I want to know how this concept is worked out. Definitely looking forward to that one, but besides that, I don't know of any new releases. Oops. Number 5 is biggest disappointment. For this one, I also have, I think, a book that a lot of people felt disappointed about, and that is The Queen of Nothing by Holly Black. This is the third and final book in the Cruel Prince trilogy. I was looking forward to this story so incredibly much. I read it somewhere in January and I just enjoyed it. But if you ask me what the ending is for this book, I barely remember. And I don't think that's a good sign, because this should have been an epic conclusion to a romance fae book. I really quite enjoyed the first and especially the second book, but this one was just okay, and a disappointment. Then we have biggest surprise, and that is definitely The Black Flamingo by Dean Atta. I recently read this one through scribed. I never know how to say that app's name in English. I listened to it and it was wonderful. It was amazing. So we follow our main character called Michael, and it basically tells you his life story in verse, but because I listened to it in audiobook form, I didn't really notice that. But he tells his whole life story from a child until he gets into university, and he is a biracial gay teen, so it just deals with his whole life story. Dean Atta wrote this book so beautifully. I was just grabbed from the moment that I started this book, and he also narrates the story on Scribd, and I loved it so incredibly much. And like, I wasn't expecting too much from this book because I hadn't heard a lot of people talk about it. It was just wonderful. It is one of my favorite books of 2020, so definitely check out The Black Flamingo by Dean Atta. My new favorite author of 2020 is definitely Alice Oseman from Heartstopper, from Radio Silence. I've also read Solitaire by her, but that one is not that amazing. Would not recommend it. I still have one of her other books, which is called I Was Born for This, that I need to read as well. I have pre-ordered her new novel, which is coming out in 2 weeks or something, which is called Loveless, in which our main character is, I believe, asexual. She just has really great queer books that usually deal with more of the mental issues and stuff like that. I love contemporaries that go just a little bit deeper into everything, and I love her writing style. I just love Alice Oseman. She's definitely one of my new favorite authors, and I'm so glad that I've discovered her this year. Now, the next two questions I can answer within like the same book, within the same universe. So question number 8 is newest fictional crush, and for me that is definitely Jasper from Six of Crows. He is one of my favorite characters of the whole Six of Crows like group. He is so charming and so funny and beautiful. So this is the collector's edition of Six of Crows, and especially when I look at Jasper's artwork, I'm just like drooling all over the page. I mean, He is so stunning. Every single time that we got to read a chapter from his perspective or that he made a comment somewhere in between, I just fell in love with him so incredibly much. And then question number 9 is your new favorite character, and that is Nina from Six of Crows. I feel like Nina and I would just be best friends. We have so many things in common. I also love the way that she's described. She has just got nice curves, and you'd rarely see representation of curvier characters in novels, I think. Nina also loves sweet things. She has the biggest sweet tooth, and same. Sugar is my addiction. I think Nina and I would be very good friends, and she's definitely my new favorite character. A book that made you cry is question number 10, and I have to say, I haven't cried that much this year because of a book, and I actually really like it when I cry about books, because that means that the book made me feel lots of things, and that usually is a good thing. I think that you are a good writer if you can make the reader feel all of the feels. The only book that I could find in which I was like crying, but mostly happy tears, and it is also a book that I've showed you already, and that is Heartstopper Volume 2. Mostly, like I said, happy tears because it was so cute and the characters were so wonderful to each other. Like, Nick is the absolute sweetest boy you've ever met. Most of it was really, really wonderful. So this book, I guess. And let's just stay with the Heartstopper books for question number 11, which is a book that made you happy. I mean, overall, these books just make you so happy when you read them. Not only is the drawing style adorable, just the characters are usually just really quite grown up and they respond in grown up ways, especially in comparison to other characters in YA books, which I appreciate very much. Number 12, the most beautiful book you've bought so far this year or received, and for this one I definitely have to go with the collector's edition of Crooked Kingdom by Leigh Bardugo. I love the gold foil on the front of the cover. On the back it has that as well, with a really nice quote on it. There is just a lot of detail in the book, and then what I love the most is the fan art in the back as well. I mean, look at my babies. Oh my god, I just love all the characters so incredibly much. We have Jasper and Wyland on the last page. We have halfway bow. It's just a stunning book, and there is no other book that I could think of with this question. But let's get to our final question, which is, what books do you need to read by the end of the year? And I have a couple of them. This is The Hand on the Wall by Maureen Johnson, the third book in the Truly Devious series. And the only reason why I still haven't picked up this last book in the trilogy is because I have forgotten the details in book number 1 and 2, and I need to find a good like recap somewhere online to refresh my mind and then continue with the story. So if you know of a site that has a good recap for Truly Devious and The Vanishing Stair, book 1 and 2 in this trilogy, please let me know in the comments down below, because I need to find out what happens. But if you don't remember the things that happened previously, then it's not that exciting. And then I have 2 other things that I need to read before the end of the year, with also some announcements attached to these books. So first of all, I have The Poppy War by R.F. Kuang, and the announcement that I have with this book is that Leonie from The Book Leo and I have started a bi-monthly book club called The World Readers Book Club. You can follow us on Twitter. I will put the handle on the screen right here. We basically are gonna read books that take place outside of the US and in the UK, because a ton of books take place in those 2 countries, and we want to explore books that take place all over the world. So we put up a poll for what should be our July and August book, and you guys voted for The Poppy War, which is a fantasy book inspired by Chinese history and the Opium Wars. I literally hadn't heard of this book before 2 months ago. Apparently this is an amazing, I believe, debut fantasy novel in a trilogy. I've heard a lot of great things about it. So this will be our July and August read. You can pick it up. My camera's dying, so let's get on with the last one. And I will also be reading the A Darker Shade of Magic trilogy, and an announcement for something is coming up within the next week, so keep your eyes out for that. So those were all of the 13 questions in the mid-year book freakout tag. Let me know in the comments down below if you agree with some of the answers that I gave to these questions, or let me know your favorite book of 2020. Just leave a comment down below. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. You can subscribe to my channel by clicking somewhere here on the screen or on the button down below. And hopefully I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!